We'll use the lines as base geometry for our terrain mesh. Switch to the zero-point ground floor in the Navigator project map. Right-click the W1 site worksheet in the Navigator, and choose Show as Trace Reference to select it as a traced view. Click the arrow next to the Trace and Reference button, and choose Trace and Reference from the bottom of the list to open the Trace and Reference palette. You may change the reference color to enhance the visibility of the referenced elements. Let's slightly modify the reference color by selecting the Choose Other Color option, and then use the slider to define a slightly darker color for the display of the referenced elements. Click OK. Click the More Reference Options button, and checkmark All Types to make sure that all element types are displayed as reference. Click Apply Settings to All References to ensure that the trace will behave the same way. Close the Trace and Reference palette. If you still cannot see the lines, their layers may be hidden. Open the Layer Settings dialog using the Document, Layers, Layer Settings command, or by pressing the Ctrl or Command plus L key combination. Scroll down in the list of layers. The layers of the XRefs are separated from the native ARCHICAD layers. Click the eye icons to make them visible. Click OK to close this dialog. Activate the mesh tool by clicking its icon in the toolbar so that it will be active. And then double-click the mesh tool to open its settings dialog. Set the mesh properties as follows. First, display the geometry and positioning panel of the mesh settings dialog. Enter 2 meters for the mesh height. Make sure the current story, ground floor, is selected as the home story, and that Project 0 is selected for the 2 Project 0 field. Enter minus 0.1 meters for the offset to home story field. Select solid body for the mesh structure. Select soil building material for the mesh material. Open the floor plan and section panel of the mesh settings dialog. Scroll down or resize the dialog and select cover fills in the list. Uncheck cover fills. Open the model panel. Make sure that the top surface option is activated. Please click the icon once to enable top surface override if it's not active. Select grass green for top surface material override. Select all ridges sharp. Display the categories and properties panel. If you are going to communicate your design to any engineers who work with 3D applications, you have to fill in these fields. Set structural function as non-load-bearing element. Set position as exterior. Click OK to leave this dialog. Select the rectangular geometry method in the info box, and click the two opposite points of the site rectangle to create a mesh. Select the mesh by holding the Shift key and then clicking it. Please make sure that the mesh tool is still selected or active in the toolbox. Space-click the curved level lines one by one to add them to the mesh by holding down the spacebar on your keyboard and clicking the lines with the cursor. Notice how the shape of the cursor changes when you hold down the spacebar. Select Fit to User Ridges in the New Mesh Points dialog. Repeat these steps with the other two curved lines. First, space-click the line, and then add the points of the line so that they will fit to user's ridges. Now let's set the height of those points on the mesh that are on the same height level. Make sure that the mesh is still selected and click on a node of the second line from the right. This is the line in the middle. When the pet palette appears, select the Elevate Mesh Point option in the pet palette. Set the height to 0.5 meters. And check the Apply to All checkbox, so that all the nodes in this line will be elevated to the same height. Click OK. Repeat this action with the line on the right. In this case, set the Elevate Mesh Point to 1 meter. Now elevate the two corners on the right one by one. Click on the upper corner. Select Elevate Mesh Point again and set 1 meter as the height, but leave the Apply to All checkbox unchecked. Otherwise, all points of the rectangle would rise. Repeat this with the corner below. The result should look like the one presented on the screen. Select the mesh, right-click, and select Show Selection Marquee in 3D to check its shape in 3D. Click on the Fit in Window icon if it's not visible. Open the View menu and click Editing Plane Display to turn off the editing plane.